Well, season 8 is definitely kicking off with a blast as we head into Mayhem, the aptly named next season of Apex Legends that we can expect to release on February the 2nd. But on top of that, in the launch trailer today, we got a bunch of discernible information from obviously the different character interactions and the background information that we already know about the character. So we can actually tell some new information about Fuse's abilities as well as what changes to expect at King's Canyon. And we'll discuss all that and much, much more in today's video. But first, if you enjoy the channel, how about liking this video? And if you're new, smash down that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so that you can get alerted anytime that I drop a new video. But let's get right into it. The thing that I noticed first and foremost was we kind of can discern Fuse's passive ability. Now, if you didn't notice throughout not only this trailer, but the actual stories from the Outlands that we got just yesterday, you would notice that Fuse seems to be taking a lot of explosive damage without dying. And to me, that means that it's most likely he takes less explosive damage, which would be an interesting passive and fit the character lore. Now, a more interesting note would be Fuse's tactical ability, which we definitely have some information on here. And if you notice right here, he has a prosthetic arm open up and launch out a grenade that seems to be a cluster explosion or multiple grenades exploding in the air after he shoots one. Now, there has been some speculation that this is an airburst actual grenade, and I don't know if that's the case, but it clearly is a cluster explosion, and that is somewhat similar to the leaked tactical ability for Velk as well. So an interesting situation as we got two abilities kind of released in the last, you know, more or less 2 days that kind of confirmed that Fuse has got some interesting stuff going on for him in that regard. So definitely got some awesome information about our next legend right there. And we even got more information, as it does appear in this that we definitely got to see Fuse's ultimate ability. Now, we've talked about this, and there's already a teaser in game with the Ring of Fire bombs exploding. And more or less the question that we had was, how does he actually fire the, you know, mortar shells, if you will? And we've got some information for that, or of that, basically showing him using the mortar cannon more or less as a t-shirt cannon and firing off Nessies into the crowd, which is great to see the Nessie Easter egg added into the actual game teasers and trailers. I think stuff like that is huge, but also then tying in with the actual legend ability. Very, very big stuff going on there for the future of Apex Legends, and shows you that Fuse is definitely going to be an interesting character. But one of the even better moments in the actual trailer is an interaction between several legends, including Fuse. And if you don't know what I'm talking about the next topic in general, which is going to show us Fuse's character size. And yes, there's actually a moment in the trailer right here where an interaction between Caustic and Bloodhound and Fuse actually kind of shows us exactly what we can expect Fuse to look like in game compared to all the other legends on the field. This is very, very telling, and that is a huge amount of information, as clearly they've been struggling not to make characters tiny like Wraith. And because of that, we've got just a ton of information given to us about this new character. Now, on top of all these things that we learned about Fuse today, which is clearly huge information, there's definitely more that we actually know. And that is, we've got some King's Canyon changes that are absolutely huge. And one of the more telling interactions in here is between Fuse and who is either his sister or a childhood friend. I'm not sure if we've actually, you know, discovered that information quite yet. And she does some wicked stuff, and then blah, 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 kaboom. We now have some changes to King's Canyon that are fairly substantial if you've seen the area that is actually going to be destroyed in the upcoming season. As it does appear that artillery and slums have been destroyed in Kings Canyon, and some new stuff has been added in the area around it. So as you can see, we got some new stuff, some new points of interest coming into the new season. But guys, let me know in the comment section below what you think about all this new information we've gotten about this before you watch and head over to one of these social media links out of the three. Give them a like, a favorite, a follow, whatever it may be. It's all appreciated and goes to helping the channel grow substantially. And I appreciate you guys for all of that. But that's all we've got for today's video. So here's two videos you can check out if you feel so inclined. Thanks for watching. And thanks for liking. Thanks for subscribing. And yeah, I was able to get a PS5 finally. So I hope you guys are having an awesome day. And stay safe, stay healthy. And as always, have a good one.